So I think it's safe to say that many of us are creatures of habit, right? Like, I know I am. And it's easy for me to fall into a groove when it comes to how I edit my photos. And that includes the tools that I use in Lightroom. Now, while there's nothing wrong with using the same tools over and over, it could be a bummer if it prevents you from discovering other tools within Lightroom that could have a big impact on how you manage, edit, and share your photos. Now, I suspect that one tool within Lightroom Mobile, Desktop, and Web that not many people are used to or even aware of is Versions. If you're a Lightroom Classic user, you can think of Versions as a sibling to Virtual Copies, but I think Versions are way more powerful. But I'm just editorializing. Now, if you are unfamiliar with how to use Versions, I'll share a link to a deep dive video at the end of this one. In the meantime, I'd like to show you three important ways that Versions fits into my Lightroom workflow. And by the end, I think you will agree that Versions is one of Lightroom's most underrated and important features. All right, let's dive in. All right, so here you can see I have my photo in Lightroom Desktop, and it'll give me the opportunity to show you all three of the ways that I use Versions as part of my Lightroom workflow. Now, this photo, I took this back in 2011, almost exactly 13 years from the date of recording this video, which is wild. Now, this is the original editing treatment that I applied. And here's the thing, like, I admit, this is not, at least for me, not the visual style that appeals to me anymore. Back then, it did. That's how I edited the photo. And for me, I want to keep that version. I don't ever want to get rid of it. I don't want to overwrite it. I want to keep it. I want to remind myself of what I used to like back then. And then it helps me see kind of how I've grown. And trust me, I think that's a really good practice. I highly recommend that if whether you're using Lightroom Classic and you're using virtual copies, or you are using Versions in Lightroom, I definitely recommend not getting rid of your originals. Just keep a virtual copy of it or a version. And the reason why I love Versions though is because if you are using Lightroom Desktop in the cloud, Lightroom Web, and Lightroom Mobile, whenever you save a version, it's available on all your devices, and you can save versions on every device. It's just wonderful. I absolutely love it. So the first use case for Versions is to preserve kind of like whatever editing state you want. So in this case, this is the original editing state. If I go to the edit mode here and I tap on the backslash key, you can see this is the straight out of camera version. And then this is the edit. And again, this is a bit much, so you know it is what it is. So let's go to Versions. It's this icon over here. And if you are using Lightroom Mobile on your iPhone or your iPad or on the web, it's slightly different places. Again, I'm gonna link to a more deep dive video of Versions at the end of this one. So you'll always have an original version. And actually, it's important to note also there are two types of versions. There's auto and named. We're gonna stick with named. Basically, named is where you can create ad hoc versions as you see fit. So every photo will have an original version. That's just kind of like the reset to original function. It has its own state here. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna create a new version, and you can call this whatever you want. You can call this, you know, like 2011 edit. You can call it original edit, whatever you want, but basically use it as a descriptor to indicate what the version is. So I will call this 2011 edit, and then I'll click create. And so now I always have this version here. It's available on all of my other devices. And then what I can do is I'm gonna click on original, and that will bring me to the original state without getting rid of this one. You can see how I can just snap right back to it. And so that's the first kind of way that I use versions, is to preserve a state. Like if it's the original edit state, that's just what I do. Now what I'll do is go to the edit mode here, and I'm just gonna make a few quick edits, like get a custom white balance. I'm gonna go to the healing tools here, and I'm gonna get rid of dust spots. If I press the A key or click on this visualize spots check mark, you can see that there are a bunch of little dust spots that I need to get rid of. So let me go ahead and do that right now. All right, so that's good. I got pretty much all the dust spots, so I'm good to go. And at this point, this is another kind of like a bonus way to use versions. Let's say you want to come back to a kind of a baseline. So maybe I also want to change the Adobe profile. I usually use Adobe Landscape, so that's good. And let's say I maybe want to apply just a few very basic edits to the photo here, just to get it looking just a little bit better. So just do this, maybe add a little bit of a vibrance boost. Already got my custom white balance. I'm not going to do too much more. Basically, fixing the tone, the color, and then getting rid of dust spots. So now I would say this is a really good kind of starting point. Like if I ever want to try different editing treatments, if I go to versions and I go to original, I'm going to have to do all these things again. You know, the white balance, the dust spot removal, all that stuff. So wouldn't it be great to have kind of like a new starting point? So that's another, I said I have three uses, but actually there are four. The second one is to actually get kind of a starting point. So you can always come back to it and this is your starting point. So let's go ahead, we'll create a version and we will call this starting point. So I know I can always come back to this version here and I don't have to worry about the white balance or the dust spots or anything like that. If I use generative remove, it would get rid of that as well. And so this is where things get a lot of fun with versions because now we can have experimentation time. We can try going one way and save a version. We can go a different way and save a version. And I think that's just a lot of fun. So let's just say here I go to back to editing here. And let's say now I just want to have a little bit more fun. So let's add my favorite S-curve. It's not going to be a Brian image without an S-curve here. Let's say, you know, drop the saturation. Let's go to color grading here. And I'm doing this really quickly because the point is not necessarily to show you an editing treatment, but just to kind of get it to look a certain way. Add a little bit of blue primary saturation. Then, of course, we'll go ahead. We'll add some clarity. Let's add some texture. Let's go to masking here, and let's create a sky mask over here. With the sky mask, we're going to dehaze just to give a bit more contrast to the sky. Let's go back here. I'm going to desaturate the colors a bit. And then we'll add just kind of a basic vignette. Okay, so there's my treatment again, /original. And that's my kind of new treatment, just, you know, to show you a different way to do things. So what I can do now, this is kind of the third use case of versions and probably the most common. If we go to versions here, I can go ahead and create a new version. I'll call this 2024 color edit. And you can obviously be as descriptive as you want to be, but there you go. Now, let's say I want to go a completely different direction with my treatments here. Well, again, because I have the starting point version, I can click on it. It brings me right back to the state where we got the custom white balance, we corrected tone and color, and we got rid of the dust spots. See here, if I go to the remove tool and I click here to visualize spots, all of those dust spots are gone. So let's say now I'm like, you know what, let's try a different profile. Let's say I want to go to black and white. And I'll hover over a few of these. Actually, this one here, three look nice. I'll go ahead back to the edit pane here. Let's add again a little bit of an S curve. That's a bit too much highlight, but let's really kind of fade it out, something like that. And let's go ahead and cool the white balance color temperature a little bit. All right, so that's looking good there. And this is a totally different treatment. So what I can do is I can go to versions here and create another version, and I'll call this 2024 black and white edit. All right, so now you could see as I hover over these, I have all of these different options and I can create a version for every treatment I want. Now here's the cool thing. Let's say I want to export this color edit. I don't even need to apply it. I can click on the ellipsis over here and I can just select export with the settings. That'll bring me to the export screen here and I'm good to go. And so that is the third way to use versions. Again, to recap, the first way is to kind of capture your original treatment. The second way is to create a starting point. So if you ever want to come back without having to redo all the things, you've got that. And then the third way is to create varying treatments. So if you want to experiment with different profiles or just different techniques, you can do that. The fourth use of versions is probably the most important because it has to do with how you share your photos on social media. But before I share that with you, I just want to take a few seconds to tell you about my course called Lightroom Everywhere. So I'm talking to you about versions, which is just one feature in all of Lightroom. Lightroom is a very powerful ecosystem of apps on the desktop, on mobile, and on web. Lightroom Everywhere is my premier course with over 10 hours. of easy-paced lessons. There is no other course that is as comprehensive about Lightroom as Lightroom Everywhere. So I hope you check it out. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. And again, if you want to learn absolutely everything there is to know about Lightroom, please do click on that link. All right, back to the fourth use of versions. So I mentioned that the fourth use of versions has to do with how you share your photos. So if I wanted to share my photo like this, no problem, right? Like I could just go ahead and just share the photo, right click, go to export, and then share it however I want. But let's say I want to share this on Instagram. And let's say on Instagram, let's first start with a square. Let's say I just want to start with a square crop. So I can go to crop over here, change the aspect to 1:1, which is square, and then I can go ahead and, you know, position the crop box how I see fit. So let's say that is the crop I want. Now, I don't want to have to keep going back and forth and changing things and undoing things. So what I can do here is I can go to versions, and I'm going to create a version here, and I'm going to call this square crop. And so I know that this will always be my square crop. Now, let's say I want to share a vertical version. So in Instagram, it's a 4:5. This is a 1:1. So what I can do is I can go back to that version. Again, you can see we're snapped back here. I'll go to cropping, and I'm going to select 5:4. Now, it's 5:4 because we are in a horizontal aspect ratio. Now, if I press on the X key, it'll switch to vertical, which is basically 4:5. I'll go ahead. I'll just kind of tighten this crop here. And now we have this new crop. And guess what? Now I can go to versions and create a 4:5 crop. And again, I can just select on the ellipsis and export these. I can also go to this top ellipsis and just export all of the versions. And I have these two presets here. All of my named versions, I can either export them using the JPEG small or the JPEG large presets. JPEG large will export it at the full resolution available. And JPEG small, I think, is like 2048 pixels, something like that. Perfect for social media. But the point is that now I can just hop between these different crops. And I do this with most of my photos, especially the ones I know I'm going to share to Instagram. I just like having different crops available for me. Of course, another popular aspect ratio is 16:9. So I can go here again, adjust my crop box, and then go to versions, and I can save this one as a 16:9 crop. So I always know which one is which. All in all, I think versions is really powerful, and I wanted to create this video to kind of get it in front of you again, because it is worth paying attention to. Remember, it's available in Lightroom Desktop, Lightroom Mobile, and Lightroom Web. Again, if you want a more deep dive of how versions works, check out this video. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, if you found it helpful, thumbs up is always appreciated. And be sure to click on the subscribe and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot.